Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice.
Welcome aboard our Independence. This is our platform for research expeditions in the Mediterranean. On board, we don't only have space for up to 7 scientists, but we also have a fair bit of equipment to offer for exactly those people. But before we get into this, let's have a quick look around and meet a part of the crew. Manuel is our skipper on board and also happens to be a marine biologist. After spending more than 15 years on boats and sailing around the world, the currents brought him back to the Mediterranean Sea. During the days at sea, you will most likely encounter him in the cockpit. This is not only the place to steer the boat and manipulate the sails, but also the part of the boat where you can get a lot of useful information, just like the current position of the boat, depth of the water, and a lot more. Pino is also part of the constant crew aboard Independence. She's an archaeologist by education, but has been on board with us for years now. Especially ahead of expeditions, she is the one staying in contact with the participants. Also during the trips, she is the one who makes sure everyone is doing all right. Part of that is organizing food, which happens here.
Welcome on board Independence. Right now, this is the entrance, and when you enter on your right side, here's our kitchen. And this area, actually, where we sit together, show things to each other. So beginning of the day or end of the day, we come together, sit around this table, and we discuss the things throughout what happened throughout the day.
Opposite the cooking area, you can already find the table, which is not only for eating and meetings, but also the main working area inside. Under the seats, we also store microscopes to have a very close look at the samples we collect throughout the days. In the same area, you can also already find the first two bunks, which is what we call beds on the boat. With certainly the shortest trip to the galley, as well as the table, this is the best spot for early risers. A few steps further forward, we have yet another cabin, in which 2 to 3 more people can find a space to sleep in comfort. And just aft of that cabin again, some more storage space, which is where, for example, our beach cleanup kit finds a home. Yet another piece of kit that is stored in this area is our ROV, an underwater drone, that can dive down to 100 meters of depth, enabling us to look at things well out of diving range. For the smallest parts of our research work, we also have a plankton net on board. We can use this not to only catch plankton, but also microplastics, and get a better idea of the amount of rubbish in the water. This work is one of our main focus points in this season. The chart table is another useful spot on the boat. You can get a hold of many bot-related information here, for example, how full our batteries are right now, that we need for cooking, use of computers, and all other equipment. But you could also find out how much power we are currently generating with the solar panels. Of course, you can also find out about the position of the boat down here. And you will also find a navigation computer with charts of the area, as well as actual paper charts covering the entire Mediterranean Sea. This way we can always work out where in the world we are. Back outside, the bow of the boat is a great area for an outlook position. While we are underway, there's always at least one person checking the surface for plastic debris, but also for marine megafauna, such as turtles, dolphins, and sometimes even a whale. If the weather is getting too rough to stay in the front of the boat, the cockpit is always offering a good shelter, even in the worst weather the Mediterranean Sea has to offer. And even on the stern of the boat, we have some more additional seating. It is the best place to launch the ROV from, but it is also the access to our bathing platform, where we start snorkeling trips and dinghy rides from. Our dinghy is powered by an electric outboard engine or paddles, and it is possible to move a lot quieter than with independents, which means that observation of marine fauna, especially fish, is a lot easier. And this year our expedition is all about you. This means that your questions, your input, and your ideas are what we need. Even if you are not on board at this time, we are already here for you. And the issue we want to tackle with you is plastic. Be it microplastic, ghost nets, or bottles, you choose. At this point, Independence is still in Monfalcone, at the northern end of the Adriatic. But on May 1st, we will set to sea and make our way towards Sicily. And already on the way, we will begin our data collection, organize beach cleanups, and if possible, public engagement events. The ultimate question is easy. How can we get all this plastic out of the marine ecosystem? And this is where we need your ideas. But first, a few more pieces of information. So why would I care about plastic in the seas altogether? First, it does not look nice at all. But also, plastic has a tendency of sticking around. It does break down to smaller pieces, but those find their way into food chains and eventually back to us. And this is where the real trouble starts. So it is very obvious that the plastic must be removed from the marine environment. And once we tackle this task, there is different places to look at. A lot of plastic does not stay afloat and simply sinks to the bottom. This tends to be the part that people forget about, since it is out of sight for most of us. And unfortunately, it is rather difficult to get there, and even more difficult to take anything away from the deep sea again. So perhaps not the first place to focus a cleanup on. Floating plastic is a lot easier to spot. It involves everything that floats either on the surface or right underneath. So exactly the part that we also get a snapshot from whenever we pull our plankton net. This could be anything from big plastic pieces, such as tarps, nets, and bottles, down to tiny particles. Some of this would be easy to remove, other parts are almost invisible and trickier to target. The third marine location to look for plastics would be coastlines and beaches. A lot of fleeting and sinking plastic eventually ends up in those places. Currents, wind, and weather transport them back to shore, where it becomes very easy to pick it all up. Scry enough though, no matter where in the world you go, it is almost impossible to find clean beaches, unless they are cleaned up by someone. And this is exactly where we turn to you. After cleaning beaches for many years now, we want to hear your ideas and thoughts. How and where would you remove plastic? The important thing is that your method works and is simple enough to use it anywhere. You can design a machine that does the job for you, or come up with a way to engage a lot of people in a cleanup. The key is to get plastic out of the system without picking any animals. In other words, pulling a giant net will not work, because next to the plastic we would also be removing a lot of living creatures. And that is exactly what we don't want. So take care while brainstorming. Here is a simple fact. Every piece of trash in the sea is causing problems. Most of all for animals in the sea, but in the long run for us as well. We all need a healthy living ocean, not only to eat fish, but also because it is the oceans that produce oxygen, regulate the temperature, bind carbon, and do a lot more for us. So if you and me, if we want to be able to take a walk on a clean beach again, have a swim in clear water in 20 years, and teach our kids how to swim in the sea, then we need to act now and start cleaning up a mess we all created for many years. The problem will only grow bigger, so the easiest time to tackle it is now. So let's come up with a few ideas together. The crew on board will happily give you feedback and is available for questions. So if there are things we should test already to make your idea possible, let us know. On our way south, we can already start running experiments for, and thanks to online videos also with you. So for now, best of luck with your idea finding process, and we are looking forward to hearing from you and start cleaning up our mess together. This is the crew of Independence signing off for the week. Fair winds and calm seas.